Today I'm serving up probably the coldest take you're gonna find about the Ukraine. Ah yes, the Ukraine, a country where somehow a current civil war with Russia is a very low second most interesting thing about them. You gotta lead with the Trump scandal. Now I'll freely admit that this is one of the more straightforward issues we've tackled on this show, but I just want to make sure everybody's on the same page about exactly what's going on here. And yes, halfway through writing this episode, the impeachment inquiry was announced. So let me hold down this delete key while crying for a few seconds. This leads me to the core of this episode, because I'm going to try to answer two questions. First, what is Trump trying to investigate in the Ukraine? And second, what's the specific reason that this is the scandal that finally tipped the scales toward impeachment? To understand this story, we need to do what I love to do best and go back in time. The year was 2014, and bad things were happening in the Ukraine.
What America is officially calling a Russian invasion of Ukraine. Russian troops spreading out throughout the strategic Crimean Peninsula.
Yes, that did happen. But somehow more relevant for this story, 1 month later in May 2014, apparently seeing a good business environment to work in there, Hunter Biden signed on as a board member of Burisma Holdings, Ukraine's largest gas production company. Now this immediately raised more red flags than a Soviet invasion. His biggest qualification for the job was his last name. Not to go into too much detail, but if you look through Hunter Biden's resume, you'd expect for him to fit right in with the Mueller probed at Trump campaign. I could go deep into that, but surprisingly, it isn't the driving force in the actual scandal we're talking about today. To understand this anger, we have to dig a little deeper. Oh boy, did he join the board of an incredibly sketchy company. Trump had two goals with this Ukraine investigation. First, reopen a closed case looking into that company's finances. And second, look into whether Joe Biden intentionally obstructed Ukrainian justice to protect this sketchy company that brought on his son. Remember, this is a corporate financial crime, so the punishment would probably not be dealt to a board member who was radically disengaged with the company, but rather the owner who was moving and embezzling assets and fled to Russia soon after the investigation started. Yeah, I'd start with that guy. It would be like trying to pin the Fyre Festival on Kendall Jenner. See, I can make hip jokes too. The main point of contention revolves around a United Kingdom investigation. Yes, it turns out that the company might have been laundering large sums of embezzled Ukrainian money into the United Kingdom. You know, because operating a huge natural gas company in the Ukraine just wasn't enough money. After the UK request, Ukrainian prosecutors opened their own case, accusing Zolovsky, Ukraine's head of environmental protection, of embezzling public funds through his gas company Burisma. Wow, somehow the EPA chief owning a gas company is the least sketchy part of that statement. So a British probe was started to see exactly what was happening with the finances of this gas company that Hunter Biden was on the board of directors of. Enter the only Ukrainian name you're gonna need to know for the rest of this episode. Remember him, Deputy Prosecutor Shokin. Now if I was making a conspiracy theorist corkboard chart, this guy would require his own red ball of yarn. He was made famous because...
accusations that Biden, as vice president, called for the removal of the Ukrainian prosecutor general, who had an open investigation into a company where Biden's son, Hunter, was on the board.
Whew, yeah, but that's still a few years out. That happened in 2016, and we're still in 2014. It's at this point that some of the accusations start to divert from reality. This next sentence is really the beginning of the end for this conspiracy. The case against Zolovsky and his Burisma Holdings was assigned to Shokin, then a deputy prosecutor, but Shokin and others weren't pursuing it, according to the internal reports from the Ukrainian prosecutor's office reviewed by Bloomberg. Yeah, turns out Shokin was the ideal prosecutory person for a large and sketchy gas company. Corrupt! In December of 2014, United States officials warned Ukrainian prosecutors of negative consequences for Ukraine over its failure to assist the UK, which has seized Zolovsky's assets, according to the documents. Whew, man, Thanksgiving at the Biden house must have been awkward that year. Then 2015 came, and the $23.5 million that had been frozen in the UK were unblocked in 2015, when a British court determined there wasn't enough evidence to justify the continued freeze, in part because Ukrainian prosecutors had failed to provide the necessary information. It's at this point when the investigation of the company Hunter Biden was on the board of was officially closed. So he was no longer being investigated from this point onward. While all that was happening, Shokin became Prosecutor General in February 2015. Hey, congratulations! Unfortunately, at the same time,
on Monday, a rally took place near the presidential administration in Kyiv. Several dozens of activists, MPs, and ordinary citizens have come together to demand the resignation of the Prosecutor General, Viktor Shokin. Ukraine's General Prosecution Office has been under a lot of criticism for not willing to fight corruption not only in the country, but also within its own ranks.
So at this point, you have pretty wide internal dissent aimed at this chief prosecutor, and still no progress being made with any of these investigations. It got to the point where the United States ambassador to Ukraine, during a speech, accused officials of working under Shokin of subverting the UK investigation. Yeah, things were really not looking good for Shokin, especially when, in 2016, the next year, his deputy Casco resigned, citing corruption and lawlessness in the prosecutor general's office. Finally, after all of this, the US called for the judge to be fired. Although the final nail in the Biden was behind it all theories coffin is, the US plan to push for Shokin's dismissal didn't initially come from Biden, but rather filtered up from the officials at the US Embassy in Kyiv, according to a person with direct knowledge of the situation. So that answers the first question. What was Donald Trump investigating? Donald Trump was trying to push the Ukraine to open an investigation into Joe Biden firing this prosecutor, because he thought the primary reason for Joe Biden to fire this guy was to get the company employing his son off the hook. And secondly, he wanted to reopen the case against Joe Biden's son's company. Now to the equally important question of, what did he do to tip the political scales towards impeachment?
Officials at the Office of Management and Budget relayed Mr. Trump's order to withhold hundreds of millions of dollars in military aid to Ukraine to the State Department and the Pentagon in July. Just days later, President Trump had a phone call with the Ukrainian president in which he is said to have pressured the leader to investigate former Vice President Joe Biden and his son Hunter.
Now, it's pretty easy to point at that and say, yeah, that, just all that, abuse of power. But you need to be a little more nuanced than that. The allegation that Trump withheld a congressionally approved $250 million in military aid to the Ukraine, a country that, I can't stress this enough, has been fighting a hot war with Russia since 2014. Yeah, they need those weapons. So, okay, Democrats are mad at Trump for using congressionally approved aid as a negotiating tool in the Ukraine, right? That sounds reasonable. Oh, here's a speech from Joe Biden from a year ago, where he takes a bold stance against withholding congressionally approved aid to achieve goals in the Ukraine.
And I was supposed to announce that there was another billion-dollar loan guarantee. And I had gotten a commitment from Poroshenko and from Yatsenyuk that they would take action against the state prosecutor, and they didn't. So they said they were walking out to press conference. I said, we're not going to give you the $1 billion. They said, you have no authority, you're not the president. The president said, I said, call him. I said, I'm telling you, you're not getting $1 billion. I said, you're not getting $1 billion, you'll be leaving here, and I think it was, 6 hours? I said, I'm leaving in 6 hours. If the prosecutor's not fired, you're not getting the money. Well, son of a bitch, got fired. And they put in place someone who was solid.
Good one. I'm laughing so hard, I'm crying. Well, this makes all of this a little more complicated. I mean, Joe, you realize the cameras were running and you were mic'd up, right? So why are Democrats so mad about this? Well, it comes down to not the action itself, but the motivation behind the action. Democrats will argue that Biden was leveraging aid to fire a corrupt Ukrainian prosecutor, which is a good thing. Yay! Trump, on the other hand, is withholding funds to pressure Ukraine into launching investigations for the sole purposes of digging up dirt on a political rival, which is a bad thing, an abuse of power. Boo! Now I realize that I'm giving you an incredibly whitewashed description of what happened, because I tend to be a lot more legally minded in talking about this. So let me just give you a quick political quote to rile everybody up and make everybody slightly more angry about the situation I just laid out. Using presidential power to withhold aid to a nation that was recently invaded by Russia, unless it investigates your political rival, sounds like the definition of a criminal quid pro quo. There's the version that'll get all the clicks rolling in. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. But I guarantee it isn't. Hello YouTube, if you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.